Good morning, everyone. I need to think over what I'm going to say because most has actually been said already. Minister Skourlaidis, Minister Lakotrypis, Dimitris have already introduced to you what is at stake in terms of IGI Poseidon project. So let me try to focus on a broader vision on how we see Greece developing a new transit corridor complementing TAP for obviously the benefit of Greece, but also the benefit of European Union in terms of security and diversification of supply. And this is mainly the effort IGI Poseidon is trying to bring on the table. So we see two new sources of supply entering Greece, and mainly and arriving into Italy via the Poseidon pipeline. These two sources of supply are not alternative, but entirely complementary. One is Russia. Now, Dimitris has mentioned the MOU we have signed in February, the work we are doing. Our effort is to develop a true multi-source corridor open also to Russian gas. Now, also is important, but Russian gas is more important in the sense that having a southern route of Russian gas to Europe is a vital element for the South European economies and Italy. This, in order to complement northern route for Russian gas, secure direct flows of Russian gas into Southern East Europe and Italy, and the development a proper price signal in Southeast Europe that means effectively the development of a liquid market in Southeast Europe. So we are putting a lot of effort in the work we are doing with Gazprom, and by the end of the year we will know if this idea will emerge into a proper industrial initiatives. Together with Russian gas, the ITGI, IGI Poseidon system will try to bring into Europe the East Med gas. Now, on the East Med pipeline, a lot has been said on the past. There was a lot of skepticism on the past. We have engaged into this project, and we have assigned the scope of assessing the technical feasibility and commercial viability of the project to world-class engineering and consultancy firm. This work has been completed, and we now can extract two final definitive considerations. The first one, the project, despite its length and the water depth it has to cross, it's technically feasible. No doubt about this. The project can be done, the pipeline can be built, the pipeline can be installed. No issue there. The second conclusion is the project is commercially viable. This means that its cost for a 10 BCM configuration with a scale-up potential up to 20 is comparable to industry standards for similar size projects. And the transportation cost associated to the East Med pipeline, it's similar to the transportation cost of other options for exporting East Med gas. So if we can take out from the table the debate on whether the project is feasible or not, we can now hopefully focus on what's the value the project brings into the region and to the wider European Union community. And in order to discuss this, let me give you three remarks, three considerations. Minister Lakotrypis mentioned East Med, Leviathan, and Levantine Basin is not just Leviathan and Aphrodite. There is a full potential of new discoveries in the basin that will make the basin one of the most important exporter into the international markets. This means, someone says, a new Norway. Maybe a new Norway plus a new Algeria. But this means that the East Med will need multiple export schemes, multiple export options. And this means that in order to incentivize exploration and production activities and accelerate monetization of the future discoveries, these export options have to be developed in parallel. Now, when we talk of, international markets, there are three markets Ismet Gas can actually target: the global LNG market, the Turkish domestic market, and Europe.
You're stealing the time now, you know.
The global international market is obviously an option that is reachable for Ismet Gas using Egyptian idle liquefaction capacity. But two issues have to be taken into consideration. First, it is a global market, means that LNG goes where prices are higher, so these reserves cannot be underpinned to Europe if it's a global in the global LNG market. Second, we need to understand yet how the market will react to the coming up LNG glut, the old LNG facilities that is coming on stream between now and 2019. A glut that will last until 2025. Turkish domestic market is an obvious second option, or other option without priorities. And this is also obviously consistent with both the need of securing growing demand there, but also the requirement of developing Turkey as a gate to for all additional sources to Europe. Sorry, gate maybe is not the right word, hub is the more sensible word. Then there is Europe, finally. Europe has three options to be served with Ismet gas: the Ismet pipeline, LNG, to TANAP and TAP idle capacity. We assessed that from an economic point of view, these three options are equivalent. Actually, our consultant thinks that Ismet is slightly cheaper, but it's not what drives the difference. The difference is in the strategic value of the Ismet pipeline. The Ismet pipeline is the only direct connection with a full intra-EU pipeline. And this offers a huge risk mitigation element in terms of not only geopolitical risks consideration, but also undisputed flows of supply. So I'll cut it short here. There is a lot of work to be done in the region, and EastMed pipeline, we believe, it's an essential part of the dynamics in this Mediterranean region. Thank you very much.
Yeah, grazie.